Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I will take part 2 of bibliography. I will explain how to include bibliography in your LaTeX files using BibTeX method. Now, let us take up the features of BibTeX. Actually, BibTeX can offer you much more than what you can dream of. You can write bibliography in one separate file and you can maintain it for the rest of your life and reuse it for any and every LaTeX document that you may prepare. Most probably you have almost the same resources for mutual purpose. So why rewrite the bibliography for each and every time? Manually formatting the list of references is really a bad practice and it involves lot of pitfalls. You should follow one consistent citation format like APA, MLA, etc. for all your references. This is quite easily achieved using BibTeX. You might want to use the default formatting. Or if you are submitting a paper to your conference, it is as easy as including the style sheet. BibTeX is not only to be used with LaTeX, but can be used to produce HTML output using other resources. Suppose you have included too many sources in your bibliography file, bib file, but did not use them all. Don't worry, this is not a problem with BibTeX because it only shows the references you have used in a particular paper. The syntax for BibTeX is very intuitive, but you have to be very careful and you cannot afford to make a mistake. Now, BibTeX styles control capital and lowercase letters, especially for article title and authors. This behavior is very convenient because it ensures a convenient uniform format for all the entries. But in certain cases, it may pose a problem for cases like abbreviations. Let us say, consider the case carbon monoxide, CO. If you use it as such, first character C will be capitalized, next character, even if you are given capital O, it will be available only as a lowercase letter. To avoid this problem, you may enclose CO within curly braces as shown here. Then, the BST file can be used automatically to change capitalization behavior for titles, whether to use title case or sentence case as needed. If you are using certain commands, like let us say LaTeX, this will be converted into /LATEX, all lowercase letters, and on compilation, this will produce an error, undefined control sequence. This can also be avoided by enclosing such commands within braces as shown here. Now, same problem occurs in the case of characters with the accents and special characters like this. In all those cases, the problem can be resolved by enclosing them within curly braces, as shown in the example here, title equal to writing curriculum vitae. Then, when more than one name is present in the author or editor fields, they have to be separated by and, a space before and after the word and. Normally, we write it first author, comma, second author, comma, etc. Before the last author, we add and. But here in BibTeX file, and is used as a keyword to separate the authors. Each name, according to BibTeX, has got four parts. name, one, surname, junior. The surname is mandatory. All other parts are optional. BibTeX accepts two different syntaxes for names. The first one is name, first name, one part, then surname. For example, Pico della Mirandola has to be written as like this. The second format is one, surname, junior, and then name. For example, Pico della Mirandola second has to be written as della Mirandola, comma, second, comma, Pico. The BST file takes care of abbreviating or not the names. For example, if you have got only one author, it has to be written like this, author equal to open curly brace, the surname, comma, followed by other names. Let us say you come across in the Indian context, Ramesh Kumar Gupta, then it has to be RK, R dot K dot Gupta, or Gupta comma R dot K. If the list of authors or editors is too long, it can be ended by and others, and this will be formatted by the style as etl. You give the author name like this, and if the list is too long, use and others, then it will be formatted as etl. One major problem with standard BibTeX style is it does not accept web addresses. One possible solution is to use this particular structure at miss, and then you can use how published equal to this. Or if you are using NATBIB package, you can use plain NAT or abbrev NAT that comes with NAT package. Then even with the article field, you can use URL equal to so much, this thing. But one very important point is, in such a case, you have to ensure that break URL is loaded after hyperref package to support breaking links into several parts while retaining the hyperlink. Then there are standard styles available. The first one is unsort. Ignore the top line. The first style is unsort. The references will be labeled numerically in the same order in which they appear in the body of the text. Then second style is plain. This is normal style. First the list is arranged in alphabetical order and then labeled numerically. Third style is alpha. Same as plain, except that entry labels are used. Fourth one is abbrev. Same as plain, except it uses abbreviations for first names, month names, and journal names. The commands used for citations and their outputs are shown here. Suppose you simply say cite T, then bib label John 90, then it will be formatted as John Seattle 1990. Then if you give cite T star, all the author names will be available, not as etl, all the author names will be available in the output. For cite P, both the author names and year will be enclosed within parentheses. In the case of cite T, only year will be available in parentheses. Similarly, for cite P star, all the authors are listed. With the cite P, if you use only one option bracket, then what you are given in the option bracket will be available after the citation, like this. If you use two option bracket, in the first case E dot G dot, and then in the second case chapter 2, then what you give in the first square brackets will be available before the citation, and what you are given in the second square bracket will be available after the citation. Then you can have cite author. It gives only author names. Cite author star will give all the authors. Cite year will give only the year. Cite ALT produces author name and year without the parenthesis. Cite ALP does the same thing. One small difference is, in the case of cite ALP, there is a comma after author name. Then, suppose you have cite T, the label produces this output. You can use capital C here, cite T, the same label will capitalize this D and make it available in the output. One special case is, suppose you define cite apostrophe S, appos, cite appos, like this, def cite appos hash 1, etc. Then you can use this command cite appos, then bib label will produce John Etels and then etc. In addition to the NatBib package for author year citation, there are other possibilities existing. One of them is new APA bibliography style file. Here there are three separate items of information are included in the bib item. Bib item followed by square brackets. It has got three separate items. First one is full author list within curly braces. Again, in the second pair of curly braces, the abbreviated list. The third pair of curly braces, the year. The same effect can be got with Harvard style, but here we don't use bib item, we use Harvard item. Within the square brackets, you have Jones et al. And then full author's name, and then year, and then bib label. Or you may use APA like BST. Again, it uses a style of its own. But in all these cases, you can have author year citation possible. This presentation is supposed to help you to fully understand the possibilities with the BibTeX. I do not intend to deter you by posing the complexities of using BibTeX. In the next video, I will tell you, I will explain, I will demonstrate why BibTeX is so much popular, why it is the one I advocate. Your job will be made very, very simple in that case. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you very much.